Hello students, see to 10th standard and 11th standard, some topics are missing. The bridge is required, the connection is missing. So today I'm going to introduce a new topics. Actually these topics you've not studied in 10th standard and you're not going to learn in 11th standard. These topics are missing. Okay, so some topics are required for physics as well as for math, okay, for the 11th standard. So I'll call this topic as a bridge course. So I'm going to connect the 10th standard and 11th standard using some new topics which you are not going to learn in 11th standard and you are not learning 10th standard. So the first topic under this heading is logarithm. Anyone heard about this logarithm or log? In short, you maybe heard about this log. See, this topic is required for maths, for the board, for physics, for board, as well as for all the entrance exams. Remember, this is a very important topic. It is missing in 10th CBSE as well as in 11th CBSE topics or syllabus. So, I'm going to introduce what I mean by logarithm for you for this. Just introduction, remember, I'm not going to give a complete or detailed explanation of logarithm. This introduction, which is required for physics and maths in 11th standard. Okay, yeah, let me start with one simple equation. Suppose question is like this: solve 2 power x is equal to 32. If I ask with you, solve 2 power x is equal to 32, I hope most of them will answer this question, right? What is the answer? Yes, answer is x is equal to 5. How it is possible? How you can answer x is equal to 5 directly? Because you know that 2 power 5 equal to 32, so directly you will compare this expression with this and you will give the answer x is equal to 5. See, I'll bring one very small change to this equation. 2 power x is equal to 31. See, only one number is reduced. Remaining expression almost same. When you compare this, percentage is maybe 0.01% is a difference. But can you solve this? Can you give me the solution of x? Is it possible? Now you can say, sir, maybe this is 4.999 something like that. Yeah, but can you give me the exact value? No, because you don't have a number, an integer as a power of 2 which gives 31. You don't have an integer value which satisfies this expression. So you can't solve this, right? For your level I'm telling, okay? But for your level, definitely can't write some x is equal to, right? So to solve this type of equation, we need this concept called logarithm. So when this topic is introduced to maths, see this. Suppose you want to solve an equation a power x equal to b. If you want to solve an equation a power x is equal to b with some restriction. What are the restriction? You know, you studied in indices in 10th standard. The base should be always greater than 0. Right? No? Base cannot be 0. As well as base should be different from 1. If it is 1, it will become an identity, it will not remain as an equation, okay? Okay, let me give someone an example for that, because you should know the difference between the identity and equation. Suppose a is equal to 1, 1 power x must be equal to 1, whatever x, it should be 1. So 1 equal to 1, this is an identity, not an equation. It is an identity, not an equation. Here nothing is there to solve, remember that. But if a is not equal to 1, then it will become an equation, not an identity. Remember, a cannot be negative and a is not equal to 1. Okay, with this restriction, if you want to solve this for any n, for any real number n, b, if you want to solve this equation, suppose situation is like this, 100% you require logarithm. Remember that. To solve this problem, yeah, definitely logarithm is not required because you know some information related to this, so you can answer it. But for this situation, or maybe 2 power x is equal to 15, suppose it is 16, you know, right? Suppose it is 15, you can't. So for manage this situation, you need logarithm. So to solve this equation, a power x is equal to b, you need logarithm. So logarithm is nothing but log of a to the base, log of b to the base a is equal to x. Maybe you saw this, log of some number to the base. See, logarithm is nothing but solution of a power x equal to b. What do you mean by solution of a power x equal to b? The value of x which satisfies the equation. So solution is always for x. So x is equal to log of b to the base 2. So log is introduced, let this to the mass. So logarithm, why it is required? To solve an equation of the form a power x is equal to b. I'll explain the examples here. I'll take the example which I wrote already in the beginning, okay? 2 power x is equal to 32. I'll show you how it will work because you know this answer. Okay, suppose question is solve. Just assume you don't know 2 power 5 is equal to 32, then you cannot solve directly like this. So let me use logarithm. According to the definition of logarithm, solution of this equation is log of 32 to the base 2. Okay, so now we need x value. See, here you can write actually log of 2 power 5 to the base 2. This you know, right? Now, to answer this equation using logarithm, we need some properties. Okay, we need some properties of logarithm. Remember that. So, using those properties, okay, you are going to solve this using logarithm if you don't know this expression. Okay, so let me introduce now some important properties or some identities of logarithm. This you are going to use in physics as well as in maths. Okay, maybe not only physics and maths, it will be useful for chemistry also. Okay, see some standard logarithm or properties of logarithm. So let me call this as a properties, and I will solve this problem. After this, I will solve this problem using logarithm for the known example. First one, log of 1 to any base. Yeah, here even if you don't know anything about logarithm, you can answer this question because you know when a powers will become 1. For what is the power of a? For that, answer is equal to 1. What is the answer? A power 0 is equal to 1. So log of 1 to anything, to any base, it is always equal to 0. Very, very, very useful value. Log of 1 to any base is always equal to 0. Definitely you are going to use this in physics, chemistry, as well as in maths. So please remember this standard value. So next one, log of a to the base a. Can you give me the value, or can you give me the power of a which gives again a? What should be the power of a which gives again a? It must be 1. So what is the log of a to the base a? It is always is equal to 1. Very important, the standard logarithm. So log of 1 to anything is 1, 0. Log of a to the base a is always is equal to 1. Please remember, these topics you are not going to learn in a regular class, and you are not studied up to 10th standard. So this is compulsory as a bridge course for your 11th standard for physics, maths and chemistry. Please remember that, So if you search NCERT textbook, you will not get this information. Remember. So log of a to the base a is equal to 1. Log of anything to the same base is always equal to 1. Next, log of a to the power b to the base a. What will happen to this? Log of a to the power b to the base a. See, the property says that when the base of the expansion, exponential, and the logarithm is same, answer is b. Answer is b. For example, log of 32 to the base 2. I told you we can solve this problem using some property. The property is this one. See, according to this property, if I write 32 as a 2 power 5, then these two get cancelled. Answer is 5. So, using this property, this problem you can solve very easily. 5. So, log of a to the power b to the base a is equal to b. Remember, example is there in board. Next one. Suppose it is like this. A power log of b to the base a. Then also, see, this base and this base is same. So, answer is this b. This is very useful property. Again, for all the three different subjects. So, remember these four standard properties. Log of 1 to the base a is equal to 0. Log of a to the base a is equal to 1. Log of a to the power b to the base a is equal to b. A power log of b to the base a is equal to b. Remember that. Now, I'll explain the next three properties. Again, these properties are very very useful for okay physics, chemistry and maths. The fifth property of logarithm, very important, okay, very useful for chemistry people also, okay, to learn chemistry problems, to solve chemistry problem. Log of m into n to the base a is log m to the base a plus log of n to the base a. What is the main purpose of this? See, this will help you to add two logarithms. This will help you to add two logarithms. See, log of 5 to the base 2 plus log of 10 to the base 2. Then you can add. How to add? The properties is that this is also equal to 5 into 10 to the base 2. Observe carefully. You can add only if the bases are same. The main purpose is addition. The another purpose of this is when you compare the multiplication, when you compare the multiplication and addition, which is easy? Multiplication and addition, which is easy? Yeah, everyone will tell that addition is easy compared to multiplication. Now observe carefully, okay, how it works. When you take log too difficult, what is difficult? The multiplication. After taking log to difficult part, it will convert into easier part. Did you observe that? The product will become addition. This is the difficulty, this is the multiplication, it will convert into addition. The second purpose of this formula is converting the difficult simplification into simple form. Okay, so remember there are two purposes. One is addition, another one is converting into the difficult part into easier part. So very useful. Log of m power m into n to the base a is equal to log of m to the base a plus log of n to the base a. Thank you.